Welcome to this video about advanced functionality in LS Nav Replenishment. My name is Martin Kleindl, and I am Product Director for LS Fashion and Replenishment at LS Retail. Purchase and transfer thresholds are part of the LS Nav Replenishment Suite, which is fully integrated in LS Nav. The business goal of thresholds is to help you reducing transportation and handling cost. This is achieved by avoiding small transfer orders between warehouses and stores, and by optimizing your purchase orders. The threshold management functionality introduces new actual field to the replenishment purchase and transfer journals. You can now easily see, beside the quantity, the weight, cubage, sales amount, cost amount, and expected profit amount for a complete replenishment journal, the replenishment lines, and the detail lines. Of course, you can set up which fields should be shown to the users. On the journal page, there is a new fast tab called Information, where the new fields are displayed. And of course, you can see this information on line and detail line level 2. The next step is to define thresholds to compare with the actual fields. Those threshold values are minimum or maximum limits, and you can define those for different journal types, vendors, item groups, and date periods, but also for specific warehouses and stores. You can have multiple rules in parallel. The rules, as shown in this example, will prevent the system from placing an order with more than 7,500 kg, which is a small truck, from a replenishment journal, or to order audio products with a cost amount less than 10,000. And it will prevent you from creating transfer orders from the warehouse to the stores with an expected profit amount of less than 2,500. We don't want our transporters to drive half empty. It is better to wait for another day until there is enough to carry. If a journal violates a threshold rule, an exception is raised. You can set up the system that exceptions are just warnings, but you can also block the creation of transfer and purchase documents. If that's the case, you need to accept the exceptions to be able to create the documents, or you adjust the quantity to fulfill the business rules. To handle exceptions, you open the thresholds page to see the violations. In this page, you can accept the exceptions, line by line or all in one. Alternatively, you can open the details page, which will show you the affected replenishment journal lines. You can easily adjust the quantities and when done, simply recalculate the actual values. If you managed to solve an exception, it will no longer block you from creating the documents. Summing up, the purchase and transfer thresholds in LS Nav are easy, simple and fast to use. For the first time, you can see the actual quantity, weight, cubage, and value of your replenishment journal on total and detailed level. The flexible rules engine enables you to create your own business rules. And if those rules are violated, exceptions are created, which can be solved with an easy-to-use workflow. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you have questions, or want to learn more how LS Nav Replenishment can improve your business, please reach out to us, either to our consulting department or to me at martin.kleindl@lsretail.com. Thank you very much. Goodbye.